Hi, my name is Johnny Vaught, and this is The Review, where I review the latest and the greatest movies. This week, I'm going to be discussing Bohemian Rhapsody. Before we get to that, just a little bit about me and the show. Here on The Review, I will always offer my recommended viewing guide. I will recommend that you go and see it if I think that it is worth the price of admission. I'll recommend that you stay home and stream it if I think that you'll be able to enjoy it just as much from the comfort of your own screen. And I will recommend that you skip it if I did not enjoy it, and I don't think that you did or will either. Now, also, going into this movie, I was excited and scared. I was certainly a little bit nervous because some of the previews for Bohemian Rhapsody as it got closer to the premiere date left me thinking, what is this movie actually going to be about? And also I was nervous that maybe the music wouldn't sound quite right, and I was excited because I really have always enjoyed Queen. I remember when we used to go camping, my stepdad and mom would always bring a lot of different like stuff to listen to, and Queen was always something that really came up a lot. They definitely have great songs, tons of bangers, and we all know and love them. So, going into Bohemian Rhapsody, a little excited, a little bit scared, and I'll tell you what, and I'm not going to belabor the point, Bohemian Rhapsody is trash and you should not watch it. I'm absolutely going to recommend that you will skip it, and I'm going to make my case now. Now, I am a hairstylist, and I was really into some of the styles shown in this movie, though I would say that you could absolutely treat yourself to a Google image search, look up the band, and see how they actually looked. I think that most of the content that was enjoyable in Bohemian Rhapsody could be better enjoyed just treating yourself, find some actual clips of the band, find some actual pictures, some primary sources. And just like go ham, treat yourself. Enjoy the actual experience of enjoying Queen. Whereas I thought that the movie, first of all, seemed like propaganda for Queen the band without necessarily Freddie Mercury being taken into account. I thought that the changes that they made to the timeline were awful and certainly made the movie confusing. Now, this movie's production did go through many, many changes. There were multiple different directors and writers and stars attached at different points. And I do believe that the reason that that was is because Roger and Brian, two of the remaining members of the band, wanted to really make sure that they were portrayed in the best light. And to do that, I do think that they villainized Freddie Mercury, who certainly could have been a full star of his own biopic movie. I was saying, best case scenario, this would remind me of Walk the Line, and from now on, worst case scenario, a music biopic is going to remind me of Bohemian Rhapsody. So, honestly, there were so many moments in this movie where it could have been cool, and they chose to take the route that was not cool, I would say. Part of the thing that really, really grinded my gears was that they didn't ever really perform. It was all lip syncing. Rami Malek, the star of this movie, was never the one singing, and if he was singing, his voice was blended with another singer as well as Freddie Mercury's, and I think it came across in his performance, which I think was stilted and certainly not given the opportunity to really embody the character. I do think that wigs and a costume do not necessarily make a performance, and I think that his performance especially was really handcuffed by the production itself. I have my wonderful wife in the studio today. She was maybe going to be on the show, but then she didn't enjoy this very much, and we were talking about it earlier, and she certainly had some other points, and I'm just going to look over to her and see if she wants to shout any out right now to make sure I like hit every point. Anything else?
It was never like Freddie Mercury never got to have any fun.
If you didn't hear that, she really wanted to make sure that everybody knows that Freddie Mercury did not get to have any fun in this movie. He was certainly portrayed as a sad sack, and while I don't know if that was the case, it certainly wasn't what I thought of him going into this movie. But coming out of it, I think what Brian and Roger want you to know is that Freddie Mercury was nothing without them, and only something because of them, which seems hurtful and like rewriting history, and what an odd thing to do to someone who I'd imagine you cared about. You were in this like massively successful group for so many years. Really weird to just like take somebody and like drag them through the mud. I thought that his teeth were weird. Freddie Mercury didn't look like that. Super weird point to like make his teeth look weird. odd, right? Like, just so strange. Getting back to the hair, though, I am all in on any man who wants to, like, get a fringe, get some bangs, go for it. Super cool. One of the performances in this movie, another band member, John, was actually portrayed by the same actor as Little Tim from Jurassic Park. So cool to see him again. And just to show how the production was, like, mired in, like, not being very tight, the actor Joe Mazzello, who portrayed Tim in Jurassic Park, cool to see again, actually got a perm for this role, and he didn't realize how permanent that would be. And as a hairstylist, I want everyone to know that perm is short for permanent, and if someone doesn't explain that to you before they do it, you should get up and leave, which is exactly what I would suggest that you do if you end up watching any Bohemian Rhapsody. Stop what you're doing, get up and leave. I did not enjoy it at all. Hopefully I will enjoy a movie soon, and I'll be back to talk about it here on The Review. My name is Johnny Vaught, and thanks for joining us on Bedford TV.